Decompensating exophoria.
So keep his head straight.
He actually, at one point, wore one of those big hats with all the corks kind of thing to stop himself looking into the TV lights when he wasn't actually at the table.
It's been just a match to see because the way Ronnie closed out his first match, he was very attacking. Seemed to be going for everything, so it'll be an interesting match to see what Ronnie does in this match.
What?
I think the other answer there, I think he's going to be very attacking again, and I don't think he's going to be refusing.
Ronnie O'Sullivan
won. Yeah, seems very attacking from the first couple of shots, and just noticed Ronnie's got some trainers on there, so I don't know if he's got a little injury or something. Maybe he's gone out for a run and twisted something, so just be interested to know why he's got his trainers on.
What?
Apart from the third frame in his 3-1 defeat by Mark Joyce, Nasser really didn't pull up any trees in his first match. Has to really step up the gear here. Step up two or three gears. Friendly kiss.
Yeah, and he did a little bit of luck on that, the way he's played it. He's landed on the pink. The only trouble is if he does pop this pink, it looks like it goes just above the bunch in its spot, so he's taking the pink out of the game after the shot, so really, ideally, he'd like to land on the black and get it into play at some point in this break.
So.
He could have done with a little bit more angle on that reticle for blue, because now it's, unless that's a plant at the bottom of the pack, it looks like it could be under break after this blue.
Yeah, that was a valiant effort, but I don't think to any avail. Just while he's looking at his safety option, I can tell you that this afternoon on the other table, table two, it was all about the twos.
So Kim is a 21.
Michael Holt, Fergal O'Brien, Mark Lloyd and Andrew Higginson, they played out a succession of two all draws. So that group could not be any tighter going into the evening session. Higginson and Lloyd are currently doing battle. And if you want to see Table 2, by the way, all of the action is available for you over on matchroom.live.
Well, I don't think there's many players that'll be going for that red there. Absolutely fantastic red he's potted, and he's gone straight through the pack, and he's landed quite nicely on the black, to be honest. It's it could have gone different if I hadn't gone in.
I know Tommy doesn't work like this, but eight. When you pot a red of that ilk, you deserve position somehow.
Yeah, right. I mean, even to go for it in the first place, you've got to be feeling good. Obviously, Ronnie's, he must be feeling good in the way he's playing, to be going for shots like that. But no, he's, I've got a feeling that he's not going to be missing from here, and it could be a quick first round. Looks like he's given himself a little angle there just to stun it through and develop the two reds and land on the black.
23.
So he's a big shot, really.
24. Thirty-two.
Much like Brendan Moore this afternoon, Rob Spencer required to get the balls out of the pockets quickly because he's got a swift rhythm going, as always. Multitasking Rob Spencer, because there's no marker here, and so you might have seen him walking around with that implement in his hand, which is not a TV remote, that's the zapper they call it.
44.
So he's working the electronic scoreboard as well. Oh, and that's four away.
Running on Sullivan, 44. Sakim is in, 4.
Yeah, as I've said earlier, that I've practiced Rosacker quite a few times, I think Birmingham, and he's always had an excellent on game. So to see him missing balls that far, it's not very often he misses balls like that far. He's obviously feeling a bit of pressure out there.
Well, that was just a lunge. Even O'Sullivan would have been hard-pressed to knock that one in.
No, I've got a feeling it might be the last one we see in this match. This is where Sakib actually needs to just calm himself and just try and take his time, because he's got a good chance there. If he can take this frame, then Ronnie's going to be going for even more, so there's a big chance and a big part of this frame.
7.
Application of side led to that one being missed. Well, it's quite clear now. There's no disguising the fact he's literally going for everything. Literally.
Yeah, I can't actually see Ronnie playing another safety shot in this round, to be honest. No matter where the ball's going, I think he's going to be going for something. So, eyes on the next shot to see where he can go for it. When Sackett plays shots like that, then I think we know where he's going for it this time.
Well, this is an even better chance than the original.
Stand any sort of chance, Sackett really, really need to be clearing up from here. Because if he doesn't clear up from here and Ronnie goes on to win the train, I think Sackett's confidence, it'll be terrible, he won't fancy anything. And then I think Ronnie's just one of them players that gets in front and he just runs away with the match.
So Kim is in 8.
Nasser just can't complain about a lack of chances. Neither for that matter can O'Sullivan. Another opportunity goes a begging there. What a frame of mistakes.
Four.
And there's another one.
I think we'll still be seeing him go for this one then. If he does miss it, it's not going to stay on the hole if he hits it slow.
Five. It's a push from it. Yeah, that was a push.
I'm not sure that was a push, because if it was a push, the light would have gone straight through. He's obviously playing at an angle, so...
Ryan Sullivan 4, so
yeah, that wasn't
a
push shot, unfortunately. Because he's playing away from it as well. If it had pushed that, the light would have gone straight towards the corner pocket.
Well, there's... no sort of... petulance from O'Sullivan whatsoever. He's taken it... well, but clearly from his initial reaction he just was dumbfounded that a push was called. Dumbfounded.
It was a mistake and it's gone now and there's nothing anyone can do about it. We just have to get on with the game and there's like I said, nothing we can do. We just have to try and get on with it from there.
Rob would have made that decision with the best of intentions, and I'm a big Rob Spencer fan when it comes to refereeing, but I do agree with you, Tom. I don't think it was a push shot, and O'Sullivan's reaction was one of genuine surprise when it was called.
Yeah, Rob's a very good referee. He's, the only trouble is, he's human at the end of the day. We all make mistakes, and that said, he's only human, and we all make mistakes, but it's, by the looks of it, it's, if this pink goes in, it's not really changed the match too much.
11 and the first
round. You know, with these emotions all over the place, or at least entitled to be all over the place, the blue and the pink that O'Sullivan knocked in there was something else. They really were, well, hot under the collar. A disputed push shot he was called for, but it didn't matter in the end, because he potted an extraordinary blue and pink to take the opener from Sakib.
So many people with that break off that just keep coming up onto the back cushion, making it such an easy safety shot for somebody just to clip off a red and go up the table. If they start putting their white onto the side rail, then they can't play that shot. So it's too many people need to start learning about that break off, and actually, instead of putting it on the bottom rail, leave it on the side and let them do the work.
Not a lot of logic there and consistency from O'Sullivan. In the first frame, he was taking on everything, throwing caution to the wind, and then in the start of the second frame, he plays the most conservative break-off imaginable.
And now watch this one.
What?
Tom Ford laughs. Sakib must feel like crying. Maybe not now, though. This is exhibition snooker in a tournament.
You've just got to feel a little bit sorry for Sakib Nasser. That first time he's ever played with Ronnie, and I think he's going to know that he might think it's a little bit disrespectful, but I think we've seen the way Ronnie is sometimes. What? Sometimes he needs to play like this just to sort of enjoy it. If he doesn't play like this, then he might as well go home. But it's when you're sitting in that seat and Ronnie's playing like this, if they're all going in, you want the ground to open up and swallow it. It's not the best place to be if Ronnie's doing this, and like I said, if they're going in, you just do not want to be there. But hopefully he can just focus and stay in control of his own sort of emotions and just battle away and get a nice little break here, and he can settle and he'll enjoy the match a lot more.
Right.
Although O'Sullivan is not the world champion anymore, he actually won the 2020 version just 11 months ago. And in the semi-finals, coming back from a couple behind with three to play against Mark Selby, this is how he played. Unconventional aggression. And I just get the feeling, the one thing it does is make his opponents feel really uneasy.
Oh.
Yeah, you can see the way he's played. He's making Nasser just really uncomfortable out there. And I think Nasser's going to really be struggling here. And Ronnie's going to see that. He's going to start going for even more than he's actually going for now.
No.
And I think he's just going to run away with this match.
Yeah, Sakib basically out of his comfort zone in so many different ways. He's not used to being involved in front of the TV cameras. He's not used to playing someone of Ronnie O'Sullivan's stature. And he's certainly not used to playing someone who decides to go for everything.
24. 25.
I also think this is his actual first ranking event as well. I think he was in the shootout, but obviously let's not call that a ranking event. It's his first actual ranking event as well, I think. So there's a lot of pressure out there, so
32.
He needed to settle quick, and because he's not settled 33. Quick, this is the consequences, unfortunately.
40.
Nothing ambitious there positionally, just chipped in for the 6 points and now taking on this really tough one. Well, tough for most.
See most of us going for the Helbert Mercer, I think. Just try and concentrate on the red, but no, Ronnie's thinking about getting the other red out off the cushion as well, so. Super, super attacking here. And
running on silver than 40.
I think I've just seen that in that shot as well.
The one thing NASA must do here is not to take this personally. O'Sullivan's not just treating him with disregard, he's likely to do this against anyone. He needs to concentrate on himself, on his own task. But of course, Tom, that's much easier said than done.
Yeah, when you're on the receiving end, you always feel that it's a little bit disrespectful, but then it troubles Ronnie. He would do this to anybody, especially under these circumstances, like the group matches. I think he could do this to maybe Judd Selby if he wanted to. That's just the way Ronnie is. You just don't know what's going to happen with him. So I don't think Sakib's got to take this too personally. I think he's just got to settle down and just try and win a frame, make a good winning break, and then you never know, Ronnie might change the way he plays, but while Sakib's playing the way he is, Ronnie's just going to keep doing it, or maybe go even worse. But like you said, he could do this to anybody, so whoever he does it to, I don't think he can take it too personally. Which I can see that a lot of people could say it's disrespectful, which, yeah, it could be. But at the end of the day, we all know that's Ronnie.
And it's a little like the principle of the break-off when we were saying earlier that they shouldn't outlaw it, because it's personal choice, the kind of shots you want to play. And it's his prerogative to play whatever he wants to. But it really is something far, far removed from the norm.
I wouldn't be surprised if we don't see Ronnie play one more safety shot in this whole match, to be honest.
That's more like it, from NASA.
5.
Regardless of which colour he takes here, if indeed he takes one, he will need all six of the colours from there.
So keeping this six.
Now he can only force a respotted black with all of the colours, and if O'Sullivan knocks in the yellow, that's it. Nasser, 29 behind, 25 on, 1 4-point penalty snooker required, then the five colours to also reach spotted black.
We can see that he's actually coming back to the table needing one snooker. A lot of people under the circumstances would, knowing how good they're playing, would have just chucked the towel in already by now, but at least he's trying to give it a go.
Well, in his first match against Ian Burns, Burns needed a couple of snookers in one frame, and O'Sullivan was really loose and came really close to giving away unintentional and unnecessary penalty points. So maybe we'll see a repeat of that. Cheeky, Tom, cheeky.
Yeah, and I can tell you he's gone for that as well. He's not gone to play safe. Very good shot, but like I say, it's definitely a cheeky one.
Running
on
Sullivan 3, on the
play.
So, with what was his terms, he's going for everything, and right now he's 2-0 up on Saqib Nasser. The best he can do is to force a draw. Now he's opening the balls unusually.
Yeah, Ronnie tapping the table for that money like that break off. Well, a nice early chance for Saqib. If he can pop this and land on the yellow, and doesn't really need to go into him, but if he goes into him, then he could put the back safe. So it's a bit tricky little few shots to get started with.
So Kevin is there 3. Running on Sullivan 4.
You know Tom, you know him. He's not shown his true colours today by any means.
Yeah, he's a lot better player than this. But I mean, there's people at home that must have said, well, I'm better than this Saqib Nasser. But until you're out there and you get the pressure, and I mean, if anyone's ever played Ronnie in an exhibition, they'll feel the pressure in an exhibition. but when the TV cameras are on as well, and it's just so difficult out there. And as soon as you start struggling, it just gets worse and worse. And remember on these potting balls like that, and just having a little stroll around. It's not a nice thing to see when you're sitting in your chair and just watching it. He's getting his chances, so he can't be arguing with the way the game's gone, because if Nasser would have played well, then he could have been 2-0 up quite easily here.
What?
Now that was a better pot. Much tougher than it might have looked. By the way, while these have been playing two frames, over on the other table, Andrew Higginson and Mark Lloyd have been playing one. Higginson won it on the late colours.
Eight. Nine.
Nasser can just take the red on the right hand side out of the way to screw into that and take the red into the same pocket he's taking the black in now, then he's not going to get many better chances than this. And that's a good shot, and he, like I said, he's not going to get many better chances than this, so he needs to start taking his chances soon.
17. Twenty-five.
I'm just wondering what Ronnie's going to be playing like in his last match against Mark Joyce, because Mark Joyce needs a win there, and I think Ronnie would only need a draw. But if Ronnie plays like he did already in this match, then Mark Joyce is an experienced professional, and
32.
He's going to take his chances, so I'm wondering if Ronnie's still going to be playing the same.
Yeah, I was thinking that myself.
33.
Overcut a black off its spot. And it's not beyond the bounds of possibility that that's going to be his last shot of the match.
I think the way Nasser's played in this match, he's most likely sat down and most likely hoping it is the last shot of the match. Because he's really been struggling, and it's not a place you want to be when you're struggling, especially playing Ronnie in front of the cameras.
He can get through to the red he wanted to, and so everything is sitting pretty.
Eight. Fifty. 60.
What a well-judged shot that was.
Yeah, you can tell that Ronnie doesn't want to be playing another frame there. You can see the concentration, the focus he's on right now. He wants this match over and done with.
24.
And we've not touched on it a great deal, Tom, but the ability to switch hands and play left-handed, especially in a situation like that, it's invaluable.
Yeah, he's got a huge talent. Ronnie, obviously, I think he's the best ever. But it's a huge advantage to be able to play with both hands. I mean, I think Ronnie, even with his left hand, would be in the top 16. So to have that behind you and you've not got to get the rest out every 2 seconds, it's a huge advantage. I mean, Judd's the same, he can play right-handed. So it's such an advantage for them players, because nobody likes using the rest. So if you've got that opportunity just to switch and in an instant, and it doesn't even feel any different, like I said, it's a huge advantage.
Yeah, I think when it comes to Jack Lazowski, cutting out a few right-handed shots might be a good idea.
46.
And you're right about O'Sullivan. It's not exaggeration to say he could be in the top 16 playing exclusively left-handed. He's not as good left-handed as right-handed, but the difference isn't quite as big as you would imagine.
Well, put it this way, I wouldn't want to be playing him for money, even if he's playing left-handed, so he's obviously very good.
50.
And so, in a trice, this is frame ball, match ball.
57.
Nass is just going to be thinking, get me out of there as quick as I can now.
66.
Obviously had plenty of opportunities, but obviously he just couldn't take them in this match.
66, the frame and the match.
So the highest break of the match secures the match. Ronnie O'Sullivan, playing very, very attacking snooker, ultra-attacking, defeats Saqib Nasser by 3-0. And that means the final match of the evening, when O'Sullivan takes on Mark Joyce, will decide who tops group...